speaking this morning with Rod Bishop from Jayride. Rod, good morning. Good to meet you.
Good morning, Andrew. Great to be here.
Look, Rod, just initially give us a bit of an introduction here to Jayride.
Jayride's a travel technology company at an early stage in a long-term growth trajectory. We help travelers find and book their rides around the world. And by rides, I mean shared airport shuttles, private cars, coach lines, anything that's going to help them to get from A to B. We package that up and sell it to travelers at jayride.com and also distribute it to the travel industry. Names you know, like booking.com, Expedia, and the rest, use Jayride for rides. And in fact, we're the largest aggregator of ride service companies on earth. Again, names you know, like Lyft, and others you don't, like a great local carrier that can take you to a beach resort in Santorini.
You say around the world. What are your main markets?
Primarily, we're an international company. So our top markets are US and Europe, but we serve 1,600 airports around the world. And those airports cater to 95% of world airport travelers. So that's people flying to and from locations around the world. 95% of the time, they'll find a Jayride that can take them to their destination.
As far as the first half of your financial year, how have you found the post-pandemic recovery? Give us a bit of an overview.
Yeah, the travel recovery has come on strong. In quarter two of FY23, that was our largest ever quarter for trips booked. We're now ahead of pre-pandemic all-time highs for three consecutive quarters, concluding the quarter in December with our largest ever month of 53,500 trips booked. And that's all prior to the start of this year's Northern Hemisphere summer. So it's the middle of winter, it's off season. We'd expect to see trips continue to build towards summer. That concludes the first half of FY23. First half saw our highest ever cash receipts, back to pre-pandemic all-time highs for revenues, our highest ever operating profitability, cash flow positive for the full calendar year at a standstill operating level. That's before growth investments for the first time ever.
What about the Asian airports? Are you starting to see a bit of activity return there?
Significant amount of recovery in Asia in quarter two. You saw in October many significant reopenings. So whether that was Japan, Hong Kong, Taiwan reopening their borders or tourist policies change in Thailand and in Bali, Jayride had its largest ever quarter in Asia. Australians taking to the skies, but also international travelers traveling to these destinations. And that Asia recovery continues. That recovering trade is not over yet. Asia and destinations still only back to about 50 to 60% of their pre-pandemic highs. So a lot of play left to make there.
What are your expectations then as far as the remainder of the financial year?
We're looking forward to a couple of things. First of all, that Asian recovery trade is going to continue, and we're going to focus in new destinations on optimizing our yields, making sure that our net revenues are strong in addition to fast trips growth. Second, we're going to pay attention to Europe. We've got summer in Europe coming up. It'll be our second major Europe summer since the reopenings. And as summer builds towards peak season in Europe, we're going to focus on not just converting all of those destinations, as for example, you know, British tourists take off to the beach, but also expanding our total addressable market with multilingual capabilities. We're going to get stuck into European travelers traveling to European destinations. And then in addition, North America also builds towards summer, and we've got strong organic growth potential there, but also a brand new acquisition to talk about.
Indeed. Airportshuttles.com, you've acquired the assets of this business. Just tell us exactly what you've picked up here.
Airportshuttles.com is a website that travelers can go to find and book rides primarily in the US. It's, you know, a leading domain name and website for US travelers to book their airport rides. Travelers visit airportshuttles.com and they find and book a ride. And pre-pandemic, Jayride was the exclusive supplier there until we stopped supplying them through the pandemic. They didn't successfully trade through the pandemic. But that's given us the opportunity now to get this acquisition on attractive terms of just $300,000 to purchase the digital assets and the domain name out of bankruptcy. So it's a complementary fit for Jayride's growth strategy. As I said, best domain name in the world for what we do at Jayride, significant presence in the US, accretive to our business, and a very simple path to implement. We've been tracking this company for a long time. You know, we had a previous working integration there. We just need to re-up the integration, and we're looking forward to doing that this quarter.
Well, Rob, I suppose just a final word from an investment perspective. Why would you encourage viewers to take a look at Jayride?
Well, now's the moment for Jayride. It's three quarters above pre-pandemic all-time highs, set with still further upside in terms of Asia expansion, set with further upside in terms of European summer ahead, also Australians taking to the sky again, also Chinese travelers outbound to Australia taking to the skies again. So lots of very significant macro trends happening right now. Moreover, I'd just say, in general, the travel industry moves online. Flights moved online, hotels moved online. The ride segment is the last, it's the laggard, it's the final category in travel to move online. But, you know, moving online at will, and Jayride is here to help travelers find a better solution than the taxi rank, to help travel brands, to monetize every traveler and kind of give them a door-to-door experience like they really wanted. COVID as a pandemic was a bit of a hiccup on that growth story, but we're back and above it now. And looking forward to continue that movement to bring every ride online.
Good to speak, Rod. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Thanks for having us.